Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So good to be here today with you to share from the Word of God. My name is Henry Mulandi and I love Jesus as my Savior. I was saved when I was young and the Lord has been good to me over the years. Hallelujah. So today is a great day to be together and share from the Word of God. I am married, I have a wife, I have children, I also have grandchildren. And today I'm happy that I am talking, as the deputy governor said, I am talking to tomorrow's governors, tomorrow's professors, tomorrow's teachers, tomorrow's doctors. I am here today to empower you to be all that God has in store for you and has planned for you to be tomorrow's leader in this country of Kenya. Praise the Lord. Give me an amen. Come on, give me an amen. I am here to tell you that you're going to be one of the greatest leaders in this country. Amen. You are going to be one of the great teachers and great leaders of Kenya in the coming years. And I want us to read the Word of God today. I want us to read the Word of God today from the Gospel of Luke. If you can turn with me to the Gospel of Luke, chapter 16, and we can begin from verse 19. Luke chapter 16 and verse 19. So I want you today to know that you can be all that you dream to be if you get committed. Three things. One, you need to pray. Number two, you need to plan. Number three, you need to pursue. We are not here to tell you to become a Christian, a born-again Christian, and you don't study. There are those who think once you become a Christian, then you don't need to do anything. Things will fall from heaven. No, you have to work for them. You have to work for your education. You have to be very, very serious. But I want you to know where you're sitting today. God can raise you up to be a mighty woman, to be a mighty man that he can use in our generation. Praise the Lord. This rubbish we are seeing in politics, and I'm sorry, Deputy Governor. This politics that you people are teaching us of rebellion, I just don't understand what you're teaching to the young children. The young people that are seated here need to be told obedience is better than sacrifice. Both at home and in school and in the streets, obedience is better than sacrifice. And I don't care, you politicians, when you go out, I'm talking to you, when you go out there and teach our people to rebel, what kind of a Kenya are we going to have? And I don't care about the civil rights movement. All the civil rights movement and all that, those are things that are teaching us how to rebel. The Word of God, listen, hear this from a bishop. The Word of God tells us to obey authorities. We must obey authorities. I don't care which party you come from. You must obey authority, starting from the teacher of the classroom where you go to school, all the way to the police officer on the street, traffic officer. Every man that is in authority needs to be obeyed. Give me an amen. That is what we need to teach our young people. That garbage of politics, we are going to change that by you young men getting saved. You getting saved and going out there and becoming a leader because you are saved and you say, we will not take in that rubbish. And because you want a position, you fight and you lie. Oh, I was misquoted. I was done what? We need to say the truth and stand for the truth. Luke chapter 16 and verse 19. This is a story that was told by Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ told a story. Did you hear that? Who told this story? Jesus Christ is the one. He's saying, there was a certain rich man. Are there rich men in our country today? He was clothed in purple and fine linen, and fared sumptuously every day. He prospered, verse 20. And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, which was laid at his gate, full of sores, and desiring to be fed with the crumbs which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, his dogs came and licked his sores. And it came to pass that the beggar died. Now, I want you to observe that carefully. It came a time when the beggar died, and he was carried by the angels. He was carried by the angels into Abraham's bosom. The rich man also died, and he was buried. Note that. Lazarus died, and he was carried by angels. Angels came, they were on duty, and they carried Lazarus. The Bible is compressed, doesn't tell us everything. Lazarus feared God. Lazarus worshipped God. Lazarus loved God. He did not allow poverty to get on his way. He did not allow sickness to get on his way. He loved God, and he worshipped God at the gate. Even where the crumbs, the remains that fell from the rich man's table, even as he ate those, this man must have loved God. That is why, listen, young man, that is why when he died, he was carried by the angels. He had a relationship with God. He had a relationship with God, so that when he died, the Bible says he was carried by the angels all the way to the bosom of Abraham. Give me an amen. Amen. The rich man also died. That's what the Bible says. The rich man also died. And what happened? He was buried. He was buried. The rich man died and he was buried. He had no angels to carry him to the bosom of Abraham. So where did he end up to? Go to the next verse. The next verse says, while they were on the other side. You know, after death, the Bible says, judgment. After death, judgment. Immediately you'll die. Whether young or old, there's a judgment. You either go to heaven or you go to hell. You go to the lake of fire or you go to live, you know, with the saints in heaven. Now the Bible says, Luke chapter 16, verse 23. You see, Lazarus was carried to Abraham's bosom. And then in verse 23 it says, and in hell he lift up his eyes, being in torments, and seeth Abraham afar off, and Lazarus on his bosom. Whoa, what a picture. In hell, you can see very well. In hell, you can feel. In hell, you have all your feelings with you, but you cannot move from hell to where Abraham was. There's a very big division. Listen, my friend, as a young person, maybe you think you'll never die. Someday, all of us, I prophesy, someday, all of us, in another 100 years, all of us will not be around here, only the lucky ones. You know, and I doubt, I really, really doubt. And verse 24, and he cried. In hell, you cry. In hell, you cry. In hell, you pray. Verse 24, and he cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me. Send Lazarus that he may dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am tormented in this flame. But Abraham said, Son, remember that thou in thy lifetime you received thy good things, and likewise Lazarus evil things, but now he is comforted and thou art tormented. This is Abraham now talking. In hell you will talk. In hell you will feel. In hell you will cry. Verse 26. And besides all this, between us and you, there is a great gulf fixed, so that they which would pass from hence to you cannot. Neither can they pass to us that would come from thence. Then he said, I pray thee therefore. In hell you can pray. In hell they pray, but are those prayers answered? 27. Then he said, I pray thee therefore, Father, that you would send him to my father's house. For I have five brethren, that he may testify unto them, lest they also come into this place of torment. And Abraham said unto him, they have Moses, they have prophets, they have Susan, they have Karanja, they have Mulandi, they have Calbert, they have Pastor Minor, they have evangelists. The list is so long. They have, and some of your names, teachers, some of your names would pop up. They have chaplain so-and-so. They have Madam Monica. They have Madam Joroge. They have Madam to tell them. And he says, nay, 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 Abraham, please, if one would come from hell or to where you are and go to my five brothers, my brothers would repent. Now, let me tell you. You know, people are joking with Christianity these days. But heaven and hell are true, are real. Heaven and hell, nobody wants to hear anything like this. We want the message of encouragement, or you will be, or you will be. But we also need to remember that hell and heaven are real. They are there. And you will go one of these places when you die. I was reading a comment yesterday. I was sent by somebody saying like this, and I want to talk to you young people. It was saying, in mathematics, if mathematics were given a chance to complain or to sue, they would sue letter O and letter 1. Because O, anything you multiply with O or 0, it will never change. Did you know that? If you multiply anything, get a million and multiply it with 0, what do you get? You get 0? And 1. If you have a million and you multiply with 1, it will still be what? Let's look at 0. There are many young people who are simply 0. Listen, there are many young people who have sold themselves to the devil. They have given themselves to the devil, and so they have become simply 0. In just the classroom, the teacher, you fear the teacher, and so there are certain things you don't want to do because you're around the teacher. Immediately you get a chance to get away there, you'll do all those things, and you have reduced yourself by selling your body. You have given yourself to the enemy, to the devil, and so you have simply become 0. Christ has come here to change that 0 to something else. But let us imagine, because I want to talk about company. You are walking and hanging around with a young man or a young woman who is simply 0. She has no morals. She has no convictions, no conscience. She will say anything. She cannot add anything in your life. And so she has chosen to be a 0. If you are a 10 or 100 or 1,000 in your life, if you hang out with that 0 person, what are you going to become? What are you going to become, young people? You become what? 0. There are others who will add nothing. They will add nothing in life. They are simply 1. If you hang around with those ones, multiply yourself with that 1, you will never become anything except just what you are. So I want you today to choose whether you're going to hang out with the O's, with the ones, or more than that. Because a lot of you, peer pressure. There are things you're doing right now, because when you came to Form 1, we hear of drugs. We hear some guys taking drugs in school. And you wonder, where did it begin? Your mother doesn't know. Your father doesn't know. You're taking drugs. And when you go to the university from here, it gets worse. It gets worse. In the university, we are hearing of come with stays. A boy and a girl in first year university, they move in and they start living together. Only later on, mother and father to find out their daughter got married long time ago. They call it, "Can we try? Can we try?" Those are zero fellows. Those are zero fellows. We come here today to tell you the story of Lazarus and the rich man. You can choose to be a Lazarus, or you can choose to be a rich person. You are rich by the evil things that you do, you think. By the evil things you think you are rich, let me tell you. Because it's when you take those drugs, you feel very high. You feel very fulfilled. I heard of a man who was a driver, a matatu driver, and he was coming into Thika, coming from Nakuru, and he was high on drugs, and he was driving a matatu. And when he came, there's a flyover as you enter Thika. I'm sure you remember where it is. The only flyover those days we had. There are very many others. When he came under there, coming from Nakuru, you have to go under and then go above. When he came close to that bridge, he stopped and he told everybody, "Hey, we can't go through here. We cannot go through here." He stopped. He turned his matatu back and he started heading back to Nakuru. Everybody was screaming, "Where are you going? Unatupeleka wapi?" Eh, atuwezi kupitia hapo. He was so high on drugs. And it is a place you can drive, I don't know how many trucks. You can go through there. And yet for him, he saw he cannot pass. He cannot make it. That's what happens when you get high. And then later in life, you just deteriorate. Your mental capacity, your emotions, you begin shaking very early. Let me tell you, it's time to stop and turn around. Let's look at the story of the rich man. The rich man, I'm sure somebody preached to him. Somebody must have preached to him. Somebody must have told him about heaven and hell, but he did not take heed. He mocked and said, "I am rich, so what do I need? Why do I need Jesus Christ in my life? I have everything. I have everything." But when he was in hell, the guy began, he remembered how to pray. The Bible says he prayed. The Bible says he cried. The Bible says he saw. He felt the fire. He was in torment. And he could beg Lazarus, "Please, Abraham, please tell Lazarus to come over with a drop. Can a drop quench that thirst in that somebody's throat? Can a drop help him?" Today we are telling you, come and drink the river of life. Come and drink the water of life. Come and drink Jesus Christ, who will quench you from those other thirsts that make you a zero, that make you a nothing. Christ can make you somebody in this life. Give me an amen. Christ will transform you and make you a somebody in this life. Bwana asifiwe sana. The rich man had to learn again all at once how to pray. He knew how to pray and he knew how to cry. He knew how to beg. And he said, "Please, Father Abraham, send somebody from hell to go. Send somebody from Hades or heaven. Send mtu akifufuka leo aanze kutuambia tuokoke. Hell iko namna hii, si unafikiria tu watu wataokoka? Kuna upusi ni ule tu. Watu watapiga, watachezea. People will still do the same thing they are doing today, even if people came from there." So today you have Bishop Mulandi preaching to you. Today you have Calvert preaching to you. You have KCA preaching to you. You have the Anglican Church preaching to you. You have the Presbyterian preaching to you. You have all these churches preaching to you. You better listen. You better listen. It is time to listen, young men and women. Jesus wants to transform you. Jesus wants to transform you. He wants you to be more than a one. If you're a two, you can multiply somebody by twice. If you're a three, a four, or five. In other words, value. We are adding value into you by telling about the way of the cross, the way of Jesus Christ. We are telling you the way to go in this life. Give yourself to Jesus Christ and he will deliver you. And tomorrow, let me tell you, you can be a Mulandi. You can be a Susan. You can be a governor. You can be a minister of education. You can be a professor in the university. A professor who fears and serves God. Praise the Lord. Today is a day of salvation. Today is your day to become a worthy person. A young man and woman, today there is so much to be involved in. I must remain some time for prayer. I must remain some time to seek the Lord. I'm not going to be addicted in the name of Jesus Christ. I realize you can be very easily. Everybody, and Teremusha. See, you in the Facebook, are you on Facebook? My face is here. My face is here, it's not there. But I dig it so much there, I cannot even see people who are passing. I can't even say hello to them because I'm so busy, because my face is inside that machine. I refuse that in the name of Jesus. I refuse to be addicted to that thing. I remain with time for prayer. I remain with the time to read the word of God. I remain with the time to study. I remain with time to preach the word of God. Glory to God. Even you young people, it's so easy for you to get addicted. Refuse to be addicted. Refuse to be addicted by anything like that. If anything, get addicted with the word of God. Did you hear that? Get addicted with the word of God. When I got saved and began to preach in my village, you know what some people would say in my mother tongue? The son of so and so has swallowed the Bible. I said, my goodness, I wish I can really swallow it. You know the word, it's kind of, I'm going crazy. And the crazy that, you know, what has made me crazy is the Bible. I wish every one of you can be crazy with the word of God. I wish every one of you young people would be crazy in reading and studying the word of God. That is the best craziness. Let's close it down here. Let's close it right here. But before I close, let me talk to the parents very briefly, because they are listening, they are watching. Parents, there was an 8-year-old girl who asked her father, "Dad, how much are you paid per hour?" And they struggled. "Why are you asking me that? No. Just tell me, Dad, how much are you paid per hour?" And he didn't want to answer. So finally he said, "I'm paid 100 shillings. I'm translating because it was in dollars. I'm paid 100 shillings per hour. And that's a lot of money. That's an executive." So the daughter went away. After a week, she really begged her mother to give her 100 shillings. Listen, the mother gave her 100 shillings and she went to Dad and said, "Dad, you're paid 100 shillings per hour. Dad, can you stay with me for an hour? I want to pay you for that 1 hour." She was paying to stay with Dad just for 1 hour. He was too busy for her. Never found time for her, and she went and borrowed money to pay Dad to spend an hour. Parents who are listening, from wherever you are listening, parents, can you imagine your daughter borrowing 100 shillings to pay you to stay with her? If there is anything, parents, you can give to your children, it's time. Time, value. Give your children time during the holiday, in the evenings when they come. Give them time. You will be so surprised by what they become by you spending time with your children. I beg you, by the mercies of God, find time with your children and you will see. Because I'm talking for many children. I have talked to many girls and boys in high school who will tell me, My dad is never available. My mother is absent. They're looking for money. Find time to spend with your children. Let me finish. Are you the rich man? Are you Lazarus? Are you the rich man crying out, Father Abraham, send somebody to my brothers. Send somebody to my five brothers, my sisters. I don't want you to be that rich man. I want you to be a Lazarus who will spend at the bosom of Abraham. When you leave this earth, that you have a place. You have a place in the kingdom of God. That's why we came here. We came to impact you, for you to have a promise in the kingdom of God. After meeting with you here, I don't want you to be lost.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, you have heard it. We had a great time here in Baricho Boys, with many schools attending this rally. Many students have heard the word. Many students have come to the kingdom. I believe over 300 plus have come to the faith. And what an opportunity we have, especially for us as a church, to reach out to these students who are in schools and give them the gospel now. Teach us. We need to realize that we were called by God and employed by TSC to be missionaries in these institutions. We are missionaries. If you're born again and you're a school teacher, you are a missionary in your school. Lead those fellows. Parents, I want to challenge you to spend time with your children, because most of the times the children are crying, I never see my father, I never see my mother. They grow up without really parents, because you are busy making money. You are busy in business. You are hardly found. Invest time with your children, and God will bless you. Thank you for being with us in this program and watching. Pray for us as we reach out. Every weekend we have rallies, we have weekend challenges. The door has opened for us in ACMI to reach many students with the gospel. Pray for us and join us, those of you who can. Otherwise, God bless you. Same time, same place. Blessings.
My name is Peter Ndambiri, Deputy Governor Kirinyaga County. I'm honored today to have been in Baricho Boys, where we had this rally. It was very, very good. It was a humbling moment as I saw young men and women coming to Christ, you know, others crying. And I believe that this is what it takes, and this is what should be done. We are becoming the people to guide our boys and girls in terms of having our faith. Otherwise, in a nutshell, I am happy, and I want to believe that we shall go praises to preach this gospel to as many as they can accept and believe in the name of the Lord Jesus.
My name is Gloria Wanjiko from Cabrera Girls High School. It was a privilege to attend this rally here at Baricho Boys, and personally I've found it life-changing. It has lifted up my spirit. I've known that Jesus is the Good Shepherd, and it was awesome.